Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us in this Resonance 2016 event. I would like to introduce our first speaker, Mr. Vijay Kishan Lal Kedia. He belongs to the league of ace investors, like you would have heard of Rakesh Jhunjhunwala and Dolly Khanna, or actually his husband, Rajiv Khanna. He belongs to that league and he has made a lot of fortune from Indian capital market in the last 20 plus years. He gave me his formal introduction. I felt it is so modest that I have taken the liberty to go ahead, do some research, and I'm going to give a different introduction. I'm sorry for that, but I thought the introduction that you sent was too modest. He came from humble beginnings, and he started his investment career in 1990 with just 1 lakh rupees at Mumbai after some experiments in Calcutta. After his initial success with Punjab Tractors and ACC, there was no looking back. I guess, and he made a lot of investments in this, Atul Auto being one of his marquee investments, Sera Sanitywear, Aegis, all these companies were like, they were very unknown smaller companies when he actually invested them, and he took bigger stakes there. I just did some search on Money Control yesterday, and today his worth is probably about 12 plus crore in Atul Auto with the whatever is declared on the public promoters. And in Sera, something around 50 plus crores, and with whatever knowledge I have, it should be somewhere around 500 plus crore. That
he says it's more.
He should be more, yeah.
That's 4 years ago.
And all this with just 1 lakh investment about 20 plus years back, you know. So.
He's talking in dollar only.
I learned from my friends. One of my friends is sitting here. We have been following him for the last 3 plus years. And what we used to do was, you know, just go through the bulk deals in BSE and then see where is Kedia Securities or Vijay Kedia invested. And we used to just follow him in companies like Sudarshan Chemicals, Repro India, Ambika Cotton, and as late as Lycus. So, you know, so. We have done, and in fact, we have also profited by following him in all these years. So in fact, when I got to know about his new investment, Lycus, I thought this is an FMCG company. Can it really stand? So what I did is I actually searched in the net, found that there's something called shopclues.com, which is now famous. And they were actually selling his products in Lycus. So I actually bought them and saw that it's good quality one, cost leadership. So I then went ahead and invested in Lycus. So. And recently there was a blog as well that this Lycus company had put up a stall in private product label product show, and so it seems they are also basically he has evolved from being a trader in the very initial days to a value investor, and probably now also a entrepreneur by himself, probably at least a FMCG baron. So in fact, the Lycus company, you know, like just to give a perspective. Just in 2012, it had almost no revenue, which he bought, and then it is probably somewhere around 165 crores revenue in the March 2015. So yeah, I would want to call him to the stage, and the rest of it he can tell you himself.
Respected Professor Raghunath, I think is not here, and respected other speaker, and dear friends, thank you very much. For the team who invited me here to be a speaker at IIM Bangalore. It's a red letter day for me. It's a matter of pride to me. And let me tell you, I'm not a good speaker, so please forgive me if I can't put my things into perspective. Okay. Now the subject is about investing into stock market. So in 1979, if we had invested 100 rupees in gold, today that 100 rupees is 3,000 rupees. And the same 100 rupees was invested into fixed deposits, then it is somewhere around 2,600 rupees or maybe 700 rupees. But if the same amount was invested into equity in 1979, it is 24,000 rupees today. It's a fact. You can get all these data in Google or wherever you will search for. Only criteria was this, that you should have remained invested for all these 35 years into the market without doing any fiddling or without doing anything. You invest and just sit tight, you'd have made 24,000 rupees as on today. In spite of that, only 1% of the population actually invest in the stock market. So this is what we are only going to touch that subject. In the meantime, can I please ask the audience how many of you are investors here in the stock market, interested or investing? Oh, so many. Everybody literally. Okay, good. So now it makes my task very easy. So the thing is this, hardly 1% of the population in India are real investors into the stock market. And out of them, I will say, as per my knowledge, maybe not 20 and 25% people are successful. Correct? What had been your experience in the stock market? Will you please tell me?
Total failure.
Total failure. Correct. And what about others? Monam Sukriti Lakshanam. Okay. So this is the scenario of the market, that hardly very few people make money in the market. Why? What is the reason? Reason is this. This is what I found out, that it's a serious business. It's a real business. Okay, it's not an amusement. The thing is this, if you want to become a doctor, you are doing a course for 5 years or 6 years. You are doing MBBS. If you want to become a lawyer or advocate, you are studying LLB and you're doing you're spending 5 years of your time, giving 5 years of time for your academical knowledge. If you want to become a sports person, then also you go to gym, you make your physically and mentally, you challenge yourself, you do your homework, then you find a coach, you find a teacher, or you find some mentor in your life. But when investing comes, you don't do all these homeworks. Now the people who have raised their hands, I want to ask them, have you really done any course related to stock market? No, not a single person. This is why we lose money in stock market. Because remember one thing, this is what I have realized in my life, that no academic degree in the world can get you success in stock market. It's a very tough game. It's a different game. So that does not mean that you don't need a degree or you don't have to be educated. I'm not saying that. It is something different. If you are an MBA master of finance, not necessarily you can drive a car very well. For that, you need to take a training how to drive a car. You need to go for a practice. Same thing is applicable into a stock market. So usually what we do, we don't study. We don't get any fundamental knowledge. We don't have any experience. And we are going into the stock market to try our luck. So academically, we are not competitive. And second thing why we don't make money in stock market is for the simple thing that we think it's a very easy place to make money. And 99% people who are interested into stock market or join stock market, they want to make money out of trading. And success rate in trading is only 1%. Now I want to ask you, are you a trader or you are an investor? Investor. Let me tell you, if you are investing without any knowledge, okay, without any background, without any measurement of your downside risk, that means you are not investing, you are gambling. That is the difference between gamble and a stock market. These are very close and close. The reason is this, that we are not trying, you for investment, you need a different perspective. So, okay, and everybody wants to begin their career in stock market from trading, okay? So, as I have so many times told my friend that trading, if you are smoking, you can die in 10 years or 20 years. But if you are trading, you can die next day. This is very much applicable in the market. You have seen the turmoil which happened last month or in last 1 month in the stock market all over around the world. So if you want to approach, if you want to make your career into a stock market, first thing you should remember that you are not going to trade in the market. You are going to invest in the market. That is for long term. And there are two ways that you can invest in the market. One is through the mutual fund. And one is through your direct investment. If you are investing through mutual fund, then you don't have to worry because it is like hiring a driver for your car. Now he'll take care of your investments. That does not mean that is not a guarantee that you will make money, but there is an assurance that at least you will not lose money. Or even if you lose money, you will lose money. You don't have to, you will not run away from the market. If you are in good hands, if you are being if your investment is being looked after by a mutual fund. So now the thing is this: if you are investing directly, then you should remember three things in the market. One is knowledge, which is very important. Second thing is courage, otherwise you can't make big money in the market. And third thing is patience. If you don't have patience, because stock market speed is so high, it's like a Ferrari. In itself, it has a speed of 300 kilometer, 100 kilometer in 5 seconds. But you want to make money faster than the Ferrari. And without any academical knowledge, you want to do that, so you are bound to meet with an accident. So this is what the summary of the market. If you are looking from a long-term perspective, you will be a winner. If you are looking from a trading perspective, you will be a loser, because hardly 1% people make money in market. And so this is what the introduction of the stock market. Now I will give you a brief story about myself. This was Mr. Vinay also touched a little bit. So I started my career in stock market in 1978, but I started out of passion, out of compulsion. Passion because I was born in a stock market family. My father was also a trader, so I had this thing in my blood. So I remember in my childhood also, I used to do mock trading with my grandfather. So that was my passion and compulsion, because my father died when I was 14 years of age. My father was 40 years of age. So we had no money to do any business. So when I turned 18 years of age, that was the criteria to join stock market. So I joined stock market out of compulsion, because trading was the only thing where you don't need any capital, you don't need any infrastructure, you don't need any academical knowledge also. It's like gambling. Without knowledge, if you are doing, then it's a gambling. So I started my career, and for 10 years I was a trader in the market till 1989, as Mr. Vinay spoke. So in between I saw a lot of ups and downs. Maybe 1,000 times I went up, 1,000 times I went down, but I remained hand to mouth only. So that is the conclusion of the trading in the market. So, and situation was this, that I did not have the money to run my day-to-day family expenditure also. So I remember a time came when somewhere in around 1983-84 that I lost a lot of money in the market, a lot of money in that time, maybe 20,000, 30,000 something, I don't remember, but that for that time it was a big money. So I prayed to God, okay, God, please save me this time. If I recover my money next time, I'm not going to come to the market. So, because I had to make the payment. At that time, payment used to be made, we used to make payment in 15 days time, not like T plus two, that day after tomorrow you have to make the payment. There was a time gap of 15 days. Side. And in between, I started some supplying business also. I used to supply in tea companies, GI Wire, Gumboot, Umbrella, and all small things I used to supply, because market used to open only for 2 hours, and after that I was free, but I was not making money also. So I say, God, please save me. I will go and do this, my supply business, tea companies business. So God listened to me, fortunately. And maybe in next 2 or 3 days, I recovered whatever money I have lost. So although God listened to me, but I did not listen to God. So I continued my trading into stock market. And God was also kind to me. He forgave me for my breaking my promise. But I learned a very big lesson in that time. That was stop loss, just cutting your losses. Remember, even if you are trading in stock market and if you are not cutting your losses, remember my word, I can write it down. Nobody can challenge this thing on earth. 99% of times, if you are cutting your losses in the market, even out of one time out of 100 times, if you will not cut your losses, you will go bankrupt. Please remember this thing. If you are taking trading as your career, please remember this thing. This I'm telling from my heart. And I think it's difficult to challenge, okay? In the sense, if you are not cutting your losses, you are going to wipe out. So now coming to the trading. So I continued like this, but in 1989, I realized one day in 88, late 88, I realized that this is not the kind of life I really wanted. I came here to make some big money. I was ambitious, obviously. So not just to struggle for my, like a daily laborer, to struggle for my daily wages or making money. So I looked around in the market. I found the people who were investor, hardcore investor in the market, were really well off. They used to wear good clothes. They were educated, talking all in numbers, terminology, like numbers you guys are talking. Okay, so and plus they were looking happy also. So I thought maybe I was missing all these years. So I should, can you tell me how much time I have, please? 15 minutes.
We can wrap up and take questions.
So I will never pass. Okay. So I switched over from the investments, and I started reading magazines, started reading newspapers and annual reports and all those things I started, which what a new investor starts their career with. And somehow in 1989, I had saved 35,000 rupees. Why I'm telling you this? This is the outcome of the person who is coming from a stock market family. I'm fifth generation into stock market, and all my father, grandfather were trader in the market, broker. I was not a broker. So, but even then I did not have money, staying in a rented apartment, and 35,000 rupees I was having in 1989. I find out one stock, Punjab Tractor, as Mr. Vinay said, and I invested all that money, 35,000, in Punjab Tractor. So that was the kind of risk I took in that time, because I was habituated of living on I was enjoying my hand to mouth status, you can say. So that is the kind of risk I took, and ultimately after 3 years that stock went up 5 or 6 times. In 1989 I came to Bombay, and I started living in a paying guest for 2 years, and finally I discovered a stock which is ACC. At that time it was 300 rupees. And I found cement was decontrolled. Government has decontrolled the cement. So the after effect of the decontrol started showing, all these companies started showing in their results. So I bought ACC at 300 rupees. For 1 year, it did nothing, it boomed nothing. And whatever money I had sold my Punjab Tractor, as I said, it went up 5 times. And whole money I had put in ACC. So for 1 year, it did nothing. But after that, when it started rising, it became 3,000 rupees in next 1 year. So this is the kind of return, this is the kind of speed you can see in stock market, but you need to, you have to be patient. I sold all my ACC at 3,000 rupees and bought my own apartment in Bombay. So that is the beginning of my career. After that, Harshad Mehta scam broke out, and stock market is also very famous for a scam. Every now and then, every 3 years, 5 years, you will find that scams are happening in the market. You have to take that also in your stride, and market collapsed. All my stock also collapsed, but my cost price was still below than the prevailing market price. So pricing is also very important in investing. If your investment price is very low, then you can face all this turmoil happening in the market every now and then. After that, Harshad Mehta scam, market went down. Then after that, market went up again or touched a new height. Then Ketan Parikh came, IT boom came. Fortunately, I could identify one stock, which was the name of leading edge at 40 rupees. It went up to 2,400 rupees. I sold my stock at 700 rupees. And after that, again, Ketan Parikh scam broke out, which was the mother of all the scams. And stock market went half. I also lost my money, but still my cost price was better than the prevailing price after 2000, people thought the stock market career is over and the stock market is gone. 3 years market remained lull. And but the thing is this, we are in a rising economy. Since 1979, our economy is rising in spite of all these hiccups and all these things, especially after 1990, because reform started happening in India, that we know. So that is why stock market is a real reflection of the economy. So after 2003, market again started going up. During that time, as Mr. Vinay said, I could identify 5-6 such scripts which did really well in next 10 years. Some went up 5 times, some went up 50 times. One stock went up 500 times. I'm still holding those shares. And I still feel now, again, market has again taking a toll. Market all over the world is again going down because of the banking crisis in India and abroad also. And for so many other factors that China is not doing well and so many other effects. But I think you can understand that whenever there had been a crash in the market, market always recovered with a big bang, and market crossed its all previous high, and market went up multiple times than its previous peak. I think again India future is very bright, and we are the only country in the world which is rising. We are growing at 7%, and India government is going to invest $1 trillion in next 5 years. 15 lakh crore we are going to invest in power, 8.5 lakh crore we are going to invest in railway, 7.5 lakh crore we are going to invest for road widening projects, and like this. And plus we are adding 2 crore people India is adding into its population every year. That is incremental demand India is going to face. According to me, we are having a very, very bright future, and we can be benefited into investing into stock market. but you have to follow certain principles. I have written down 10 points for you. I think if you follow those 10 points in your life, you will never be at least defeated in the market. That I will share you all those 10 points. So this is what I want to conclude my speech. After this, I will take the question answer session because time is very short. So can I share those 10 points today? Okay. So this is what I am following. I'm learning and I'm still following. Create a fixed income from outside the market for your livelihood. Never be dependent on the income of a stock market because it's a volatile business. It's a very fluctuative business. So better be, don't be dependent on the stock market. Though I did, but I struggled for 10 years, 20 years in my life. So you don't have to go through that kind of phase. That is why create a fixed income, either this is from your job or from your business or from whatever. But don't be dependent for your livelihood, don't be dependent. Second thing is be informative and read a lot. Don't think it's not a cakewalk. It's not a magic, okay? And it's not a jua, it's not a gambling, because stock market rewards you as per your perception. If you think it's a gambling, then it will prove a gamble for you. If you think it's a business, it's a platform to create your wealth, then it will treat you accordingly. So be informative and read a lot. You have to be a maniac so far. You should have all the information, everything, whatever happening around the world, you should know. Because you never know which dot can you connect with your investment. Something is, suppose in Brazil, something is happening in Brazil, you can connect that dot to your investment. If your suppose your company is exporting something in Brazil and Brazil is going through a bad phase, then your company will also be affected. So this way you should connect your dots. And invest a part of your savings, not earning in the stock. If you are suppose earning 100 rupees, that does not mean that you should invest 50 rupees in the stock market. Whatever you have earmarked, you must have earmarked a sum for your investments. Out of 100 rupees, I'm going to invest 25 rupees in whole asset class. Out of that 25 rupees, you should invest 12 rupees or 15 rupees according to your risk-taking capacity because it's a risky business. And second thing is most important, don't trade and don't leverage. Never trade in your life until unless, because trading, I'm not saying, trading is a 24-hour business. It is not like you are studying here and you will SMS your friend, buy 100 Nifty for me and you think you can make money. You can never make money. So don't trade and don't leverage. Don't invest from borrowed money. And third, invest only for 5 to 10 years. That is the minimum time period I'm telling you. Minimum time period is 5 years. Because it takes, Rome was not built in a day. It takes time for a story to mature. I have always invested in the stocks, in a small cap stock, which became medium cap or some of them large cap. So it takes time to mature a story, at least 10 years. And second, invest only with best management and let them worry about the company and receive the wine. Usually, what is the purpose of investing? The purpose of investing is, like, suppose I think the India future is very bright. Motorcycle business in India is going to have a bright future. Tomorrow I cannot go and set up a motorcycle factory because it needs a lot of academic knowledge, a lot of capital, a lot of networking. So I can go and buy Bajaj Auto, for example. So the idea of investing is this. If you are investing with the best management, then you don't have to worry about your investment, whether market is going down, market is going up. You should sip your wine and stay invested. Problem is this, what India, what we are doing here, management is playing golf and we are worrying about 24 hours. What is going to happen to this company? Import kaise hoega, dollar, what will happen to dollar, what will happen to, blah, 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 so many things. We are, every time we are worried, then what is the point in being an investor? Let the management worry. So here, ulta is happening, you know. So that is why if you are with a best management, then you don't have to worry about your investments because he has to save his own name, he has to save his own prestige, okay? And your investment belongs to market, or profit belongs to you. Remember, as long as you are invested in the market, your profit does not belong to you. Even if you are in profit, don't think that that's your profit. That's your paper profit. So your investment belongs to market and your profit belongs to you. When you square up your transaction, when you sell your shares and the money you get in your bank, that is the time that you can say that you have made this much of profit. So don't spend just because your stock price has risen, because tomorrow you never know, stock price will collapse also. So don't count your profit till you sell your stock. And book your profit also. Usually people say that don't book your profit, stay invested into a stock. I disagree with that. I think you should book your profit also periodically and invest for your house, which is the very most important thing. So this is what you should do. I think it gives you a lot of security in your life whenever market collapses. And this is not, usually you must have seen the market that up and down, but I have seen some market for 5 years, there is nothing is happening in the market. That's a very testing time. So that is why periodically pull out money from the market. And keep a balanced mind. Don't be very optimistic in uptrend and very pessimistic in downtrend. Don't be happy in up market and don't be sad in down market. You have to tune your mind, because it's not only the, physically, mentally, and financially you have to become sound. So that is very important to keep a balanced mind. Otherwise, you will give up. You will lose your patience, and you will say, stock market, bakwas ka cheez hai. It's a, you know. And last but not the least, luck also plays a crucial role. Do good karma. That is very important. Yes. I think that is the most important thing. Try to be a good human being and do good karma, because stock market is a game of mind. You are not doing any labor. You are not doing anything. Just playing with your mind, with your numbers, and with your perceptions. So if you are doing good karma, it will come back to you. This is why I want to conclude.
Sir, what I see is entering into the stock market or buying a stock and exiting out is probably the most important challenge.
Correct.
So when do you decide, for example, Sierra Senate?
Yeah.
When do you decide that it's right? It's the right time to exit out?
Yeah.
So profit, I mean, sitting on profit is probably the biggest challenge.
Yes.
I'm sure you would also
face. Yeah, it's the biggest temptation actually. When you are in profit, you can sell any time. That is true. So that is why I said ki as long as you are invested, don't think that money belongs to you. After selling your stock in the market, money comes. So why should you sell the shares? Usually there are three points. If you have to buy your house, because that is the one best thing must be happening to anybody, first house, okay? If the focus of the management changes, if you think, like, I will give you one short example. I bought a company, Jayashree Tea, okay? The company was manufacturing tea. So I bought some percentage of the company, and after 1 year, stock price also moved up. So after 1 year, I got the news that company is going to invest, company is going to buy a sugar factory. So there is no connection between tea and sugar. Tea in itself is a cyclical industry, and sugar is also the cyclical industry, plus political also. So I sold all my shares. So remember one thing, when the management changes, management is very important part. When the focus of the management changes, or when the product changes, like the product from tea to sugar, it changes. Or when you feel, third thing, when you feel the valuation is very high, so high to resist. Like sometime it happened in 2015, some of the stocks, P/E ratio was 45. I sold my Atuloto, as you know, okay, I was having 20% of Atuloto. And Atuloto is a shares which risen from 5 rupees to 2,500 rupees, that is 500 times. I sold my Atuloto because when I bought Atuloto, that time the P/E ratio was 5. Okay, when Goldman Sachs came to me at 45 P/E ratio, wanted to buy the shares. So I thought this is incredible high price, and I sold my shares. So it's clear? When the focus changes, management changes, or the price is too high. After that, even you sell your shares, prices may go up, but you should not regret. Remember one thing, stock market is a place of regret. Every time you will have regret. You make money, you regret. You don't make money, you regret. You less make money, you will regret. That is why I told you, you have to keep a balanced mind. Don't go to bar if your stock price goes up today. And don't switch off your phone if tomorrow stock price goes down. So I tell my friends, usually, jo mil gaya, you Hindi understand, na? Little bit. Jo mil gaya, usi ko muqaddar samaj liya. Jo kho gaya, main usko bhulata chala gaya. So, yes, remember this thing in your life. Yes, please.
So what is your vision about
Lykis? Oh, this is again, anyway, Lykis is a loss-making company, let me tell you. Lykis is a loss-making company. And it will take some time. I do not recommend to buy Lykis, but it could be an inside information because I'm the chairman and I'm telling you not to buy the shares, but I mean it also. I think it will take some time because now we are struggling. As he said that we are 175 crores. Out of that 175 crore, 125 crore is coming from Africa. We are exporting, but Africa market is very bad because of the devaluation of their currencies. So Lykis is going to face some rough times. So it will take. बस मेरा एक ही विजन है कभी मेरे को पूछता ना तो मैं ये बोलता हूँ अभी तो पार्टी शुरू हुई है बिकॉज नहीं मैं आपको इसलिए बोल रहा हूँ विजन मीन्स माय विजन इज वेरी बिग ओके लेकिन देयर इज नो पॉइंट इन टॉकिंग नाउ खाली विजन इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट द पाथ एवरीथिंग शुड यू नो अलाइन टुगेदर सो नाउ सिचुएशन इज नॉट गुड फॉर लाइकिस मे बी फॉर सम टाइम सो दिस इज इन नॉट अगेन प्लीज
identify that story And are there any indicators? If they are there, you just leave it. What are those indicators?
Okay, I will tell you. I'll take your last question first. Why do I invest in the shares? When I find the management is good. Every now and then I'm telling I'm advocating for the management. Because remember one thing, good management with bad business is better than bad management in good business. You can see worldwide airlines companies are not making any money, but see the Indigo, what Indigo is doing. So that means bad, good management in bad business is better than the other reverse, okay? And second thing about, sorry, I forgot. So we were about, why do I buy a shares? I buy a shares if I see, you see, first thing is very important. You make big money when there is a bull market. Because when wind and ship sail in the same direction, that is the time when you can make big money. So why do I tell that you have to wait for 10 years? Because not necessary when you are buying stock market, maybe in a bear trend, maybe in a downward trend. It can remain in a downward trend for maybe for next 3 years, 4 or 5 years. So I'm waiting for the next bull market. I bought Cera, I bought Aegis Logistics, or whatever shares I bought in 2003-04. That was the beginning of the stock market. And I held in even the turmoil of 2009 and 2010, that was the bear market. So when the next bull market came, people realized the value. So that is why I said stay for long term. Why do I buy the shares? It's the good management and good product, competitive advantage, and branding. These things are more important according to me. Everybody might have some different view because you invest according to your style. But if you tell me this is the best, if I know the management is very good, management is honest, accounting is unquestionable, management is ambitious enough, then I will give him 50 marks. Then I will decide on the products, because the product has some competitive advantage or not, and branding. Okay. And coming to a question about trading, as you said, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala, sorry, right? Ramesh Damani. So Ramesh Damani is not trading, for your kind information. You could name only one person. Okay, Rakesh Jhunjhunwala. So there is only one Amitabh Bachchan. There is only one Shah Rukh Khan. Right. So there is only one Katrina Kaif. So we can't become Rakesh Jhunjhunwala. And we are seeing the success of Rakesh Jhunjhunwala. We don't know how much pain he had went through in his life. So, and even if he's successful, doesn't mean that it's the right path. And today maybe he's successful at the what percentage of investment, what percentage of his worth he must be deploying into trading? Hardly 1%, 2% or 5%. And plus he has a gambling instinct, okay. He has bought some horse also, you know that. So it's a gambling instinct, but not necessary that everybody of us should follow the same path and will be successful. So do according to your nature, according to your background, according to your family structure, because you have to take everything along. I was in IMM Ahmedabad, a guy came to me after the speech and telling me, sir, stock market that time was very good. He's telling me, sir, I want to trade with my father's pension fund. I just held his hand, matlab mera bhai ye kaam zindagi mat karna. Kya kar raha hai? Wo hum to dubenge sanam, tumko bhi le dubenge. So I said, don't do this in your life. You put your father's money into trading, even into investments. Please avoid, because it's a fluctuating business. Anyway, or am I clear with your question? Please.
Sir, something like you invest in small cap companies, which means you invest in small cap companies and the information sometimes is not enough to decide whether you need to invest in those companies. So how do you kind of make the decision to see that this has potential? And that's like a generic question.
Yes.
And a specific question is, I heard that you are investing in a jute manufacturing company. So, what do you see in
my wife didn't know, how do you know?
Okay.
Now I.
Sorry? Do you see that as a profitable business?
I'll tell you. How do we invest? This is your first question, like about the small caps and all. If you don't have the information about any company, please don't invest. Not necessary. Nobody has told you. Astrologer has didn't tell you to invest in the market. That is why I told you, be informative, read a lot.
Read a lot means read a lot. I'm trying to read 12, 13 newspapers every day in the morning. I'm watching all the possible interviews given by all these entrepreneurs or managing directors or CEOs on television or internet. This is my passion. Okay, I don't watch any serial. I am not recommending that you also do, but I'm telling you what I am doing. If you ask me, kya big boss or a small boss or medium boss, I'm concerned only big cap and mid cap and small cap. You know. So that is the kind of passion I have. That is the kind of passion you should also have. So if you will have that passion, if you don't have the passion, that's a business for you. And it's a passion, then it's not a business, that's a pleasure for you. You know, so you have to be informative, you have to read a lot of news articles. You can't meet the management, because management is not going to meet everybody. They will meet only FIIs and big people and Firangi and Gore and all. We Kallu do not have any chance to meet management. Okay, so that is why, and management also knows nothing. Most of the times I have seen, whenever I've listened to the management, I have lost money in the market. That is, yes. I'm telling you, this is the truth, most of the time, because then I realized one day, what is this happening? All my friends are telling me, today I met him, they come to me, CEO ne aisa bola, secretary ne aisa bola, matlab bhaiya tu le, main to sochta hu, ko agar CEO ne bola to mere ko lena hi nahi hai mere ko. Because then I realized one thing, ki why management is also failing, because management is a human being, especially I'm talking about small cap and mid cap, okay? Management is also a human being, and there is a saying, you never know what you can become. You don't know what you can become after 5 years. You don't know. So how does that management know? They also don't know. They are doing their work only. So you have to have a farsightedness more than the management. You know, so coming to your question, the thing is this, we have to read a lot. That is the only thing, that then you have to apply your mind. What is written, that is written. You have to read between the line. That is why I said, keep the information all around the world so that you connect the dots. I am telling you, I'm not boasting. Sometimes I send information to some of my company's management. When I am searching the net or I'm getting some information, so that articles I send them to the MD or to the CEOs of those company. So you have to be informative. There is no other way around. Don't go for inside information. Those don't go on your tips. Remember, please never go on tips. Ki mere chacha ne bol diya, girlfriend ke bhai ne bola, aur mera wo udhar wo kaam karta usne bol diya. You will ruin yourself. Clear? Ah, jute ka company. You will not leave me. Eh? Okay. Let me tell you that I have invested very small percentage of that jute company, in that jute company. So that will take some time, because jute had seen a golden era 30, 40 years before. Now I think jute companies are not doing well, and out of 65 or 70 jute mills are there in Bengal. Out of that, I think 20 jute mills have been closed down already because of the higher price of jute. But this Cheviot company which you are talking about is into export. They are exporting a large sum of their revenue. And in the worldwide, there is a phenomena ki organic chahiye, food organic, water organic, even chicken also they want organic. So I don't know what is the organic. So this is what a cult is happening all over the world. People are going for organic, vegetable, organic this, organic that. So jute is also supposed to be an organic product. It is an organic product. So I think that demand will come up for jute, especially in the export market. This company is well placed with a very, I think it's a debt-free company, and having a good export market. So it will take some time. It's not, I don't think that is going to happen in next 6 months. It might take 2 years or 3 years. And I've invested a very small part of my investment.
Sir, whenever a new IPO is released, in your experience, what are those 3-4 indicators that you have to look for to see ke lambe chalne wala koda?
IPO?
Yeah. When you want to invest, since you said long-term investment is what you have to look for, what are those 3-4 indicators which give us a hint that, okay, this might go well in the long term?
Okay, what IPO, no? I will tell you, usually I have never invested in IPO for a simple matter.
I will tell you, why don't I invest? It doesn't mean I like money. It's not that I don't like money. But nowadays, what is happening? No, IPOs, the merchant bankers have become very smart. Okay, now they tell, if the management says that my valuation is 2,000 crore, merchant banker will go to them and tell you, sir, I will get you 3,000 crore. You hold for 3 months. Because merchant banker will be getting the commission on the money raised by the management. So they will tell you, sir, I will get you 5,000 crore. Look at the startups, $1 billion, $2 billion. They are getting money to burn. So somebody asked me, why don't you invest in the startups? I said, I invest money to earn, not to burn. You know. So nowadays, you are getting the valuation just because you are burning your money. So usually IPO, nowadays IPO is not a lucrative thing, because management knows their value. And on 16, my value is this, and 2017, my value is this. So you have seen in the past also, barring one IPO or two IPOs out of 100, all IPOs are failed. Okay, and so I don't think that it's very important. Earlier days, it was money, a good business in 1980s,
90s. What should we invest in
from secondary market. Yeah.
But secondary market, remember, as I said, without knowledge, without conviction, do not invest, go through mutual fund. Otherwise, don't do stock market business.
Is this banking crisis over? It's been quite some time we have seen that path in the street. So you're a well-read person in the market. So when are we going to see the next click button? And where are you investing in?
I will tell you. I think banking bloodbath is not over now. Bank of Baroda has just declared that they have whatever provision they have to make, they are done with the provisions. The State Bank has come with another statement that still they have to provide more in the March quarter. But we don't know, it may continue to some of the banks may continue till June quarter. But if you get this information, especially the big banks, okay, like Bank of Baroda, if really their provisions are over, then it could be a good buy. But it's a dangerous buy. Stock market has lost a lot of money. People have lost a lot of fortune into banking stocks. And still, FIs are having a lot of chunk of these banking stocks. So I think when a price will rise, they will sell. So you can keep an eye. But if you are convinced that provisions are over, then again, it's a matter of book value. I will tell you one simple example. There are many banking stocks which have a clean balance sheet and still available at a half of their book value. For example, Karnataka Bank, where I've invested. Your homework didn't say, you know, he knew that. I've invested into Karnataka Bank. Yes, I'm in Karnataka. Okay. So, but I'm not recommending this stock. You do your homework. Just because it's a private bank, okay, management is very clean and price is half to book value. So you should search this kind of company. Even then you may have to see the pain. You may have to hold your stocks for 6 months, for 1 year, because it's out of fashion. But you should keep an eye. Yes, well, first lady.
Sir, actually, according to you, which sectors will do well? I mean, the mid cap, small cap, and large cap. And which fund house would you recommend?
Fund house?
Yes.
Okay, now coming to the large, mid, or small cap, let me tell you.
I personally don't feel there is any difference between large cap, mid cap, and small caps. Ultimately, the cap is a cap. Okay, whichever cap it is. It doesn't matter. You don't go by all these things. And one thing is this, all the FIIs, all the big HNIs, they invest into large caps. So chances of large cap giving you a multiple return is very less. But they are safer. Like for example, Larsen & Toubro, or for Reliance Industry, for 10 years it did nothing. So large cap means very large cap, not necessarily they are going to give you a return. So I don't discriminate. Usually I don't invest in a large cap, because the fun is in what? You are in stock market to make good amount of money, which should not be better than your FD only. It should be handsome money, which you really dreamt of. So for that, you have to be disciplined and knowledgeable. Okay. So better to find such shares which are mid cap or small cap and have a potential to become large cap. So on that transit, you should choose a shares. When I bought Cera Sanitaryware, that time it was having 20% market shares in India. Just imagine third company, 20% market cap, small cap at a P ratio of 5. Whereas, just for example, so that you can understand how to think, the first company was sold to a foreign company at 2x its sales. 1,000 crore rupees was the sales. The company was sold for 2,000 crore rupees to Roka, South India company. EID Perry. So 1,000 rupees sale, 2,000 crore rupees, it was sold. Cera Sanitary was having a 100 crore ka sales and market cap of 50 crore rupees. So there was a huge gap, 50 crore. You understand now? So nothing much happened, only the valuation got changed. So you should find, sir, you should compare between the company within the same sector, and you should choose your investment. Don't go for large cap or mid cap, any company you can go for. But large cap is in the eyesight. Everybody knows the valuation. A small cap, you will find nobody. Whenever I bought any shares in my life, most of the time, 99% of the time, people discouraged me. What have you bought? This is a share. What is this? Is this a company? Cera koi company hai kya? I am telling you. Kabhi kabhi mere ko lagta tha, my God, I have gone. I bought Aegis Logistics at 14 rupees, and I uska main publish karta tha, logo ko jaake dikhata tha. I used to go and tell people ki sir, Aegis Logistics company, Ramesh ko, mere sabko friends ko bula, ye dekho, everybody tell me, Aegis, what is this, what are they doing? So they are doing some logistics thing at the port. He was telling, wo to dabba hua bana rakha hai wo. So nobody liked the story. 2 years, 1.5 years stock did nothing. After that it became 500 rupees, you know, in next 1 year. So this is the kind of story you should go for.